Hey guys, I'm Kent and you're watching DiaGraphics. Today we're going to draw the American flag inside Adobe Illustrator. So the first thing we want to do is go to View, then go to Show Grid, then go to View again and Snap to Grid. But to keep the measurements on the flag correct, we want to change the grid size. So go to Edit, go to Preferences, go to Guides and Grid. Now change Grid Line Every to 70 millimeters. And don't worry if you're using another unit, it will automatically convert to your preferred unit. For subdivision, choose 13. Click OK. Now go to the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle from one of these crosshairs. Make it one big square tall, that is 13 small squares, and 21 small squares wide. So 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Like so. Now go back to the corner, draw another line that is one square tall, and all the way to the right. Now go to the selection tool, hold down the Alt key or the Option key on Mac to duplicate, then click and drag the line down here. To duplicate this step, you can click Ctrl D or Command D on Mac, duplicate them all the way down to the bottom. Now go back to the rectangle tool and draw another rectangle from the corner. Make this one 7 tall, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 9 wide, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now go to swatches and choose a swatch you like. I'm using the official swatches for the flag. If you want to use those too, you can download them in the description. To load the swatches into Illustrator, you go to this button, go to Open Swatch Library, Other Library, and find the swatches on a computer to load them in. Now click the blue swatch, click the selection tool, and select this line. Now hold down the Shift key and select every other line. Now make these lines red. Now select the entire flag, go to the stroke and select none. Now go down to the layer and lock this layer. Create a new layer and we're using this for the stars. Now go to View, go to Snap to Grid and click this off. Now go to the rectangle tool and draw a random rectangle. Go to Transform, go to the Width and make this 2.5 millimeters. Once again, it will convert to your preferred unit. Now zoom in so it's easier to see. Choose the selection tool and drag this rectangle down to the side of the blue rectangle. Now zoom in even more. Choose the selection tool. Now duplicate this line by holding the Alt key or the Option key on Mac and drag it all the way to the right side of the blue square. Make sure it aligns with the blue square. Once again, hold down the Alt key to duplicate this one. Hold down the Shift key to rotate it 90 degrees and put it on the top and drag those out. Now duplicate this one and drag it to the bottom. Make sure it aligns. We're going to use these lines as guides for the stars. So now go to the rectangle tool and hold down the button. Go to the star tool. Now click and drag so you create a star. Then hold down the Alt key or the Option key to make the star sharp. Then hold down the Shift key to make it straight. Now release the mouse key. Now make the star white. Now go to transform and select the width and make it 2.5 millimeters. Go to the selection tool and move the star up to the top of the blue square. Now hold down the Alt key or the Option key to duplicate, then click the star, hold down the Shift key and put the star next to it. We need to create 11 of these stars, so to duplicate the step, click Ctrl D or Command D on Mac until you have 11 stars. Now select the last star and drag it all the way to the side of the blue square. Now hold down the Shift key and select all the stars. Go down to the Align tool and select Horizontal Distribute Center. Now right click the stars, click Group. Now duplicate this group and hold down the Shift key to make sure they align. Release the mouse button and to duplicate this step, Ctrl D or Command D until we have 9 rows. Now select the last row and drag it all the way down to the bottom of the blue square. Now hold down Shift key and select all the white stars and go to this button, Vertical Distribute Center. Now right click one of the stars and select ungroup. This will make the stars individuals again. Now you can delete the guidelines. As you can see, we have doubled the amount of stars we need. So now we just need to delete every other star. This is the easiest way I found to align all the stars correctly. Now zoom out. Go to layers and unlock the flag again. And this is how to draw the American flag inside Adobe Illustrator. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of these graphic design tutorials. Thank you for watching.